Welcome to Bible 180 Jeremiah. Jeremiah's message is, Yahweh is sending the Babylonians to punish you. You'll be in exile for 70 years, but after you repent, I'll bring you back. Yahweh compares himself to a jilted lover and Israel as the unfaithful wife. Additionally, leaders of Jerusalem were corrupt and abusive to the vulnerable. Plus, Jerusalem has turned God's house, the temple, into a den of robbers, which means it's no longer a place of worship, but a place where bad dudes and corrupt guys go to hang out. It's not just Judah. All the nations will be drunk, but not on wine. They'd be tripping on the Lord's wrath, which burns as it goes down and causes them to stumble and fall. Yahweh says, prophesy, and maybe they'll repent and I'll relent. Instead, upon hearing Jeremiah's proclamation, the people in the temple cry for Jeremiah to be put to death. Jeremiah replies, you've rejected God's wooden yoke of exile. Try this one on for size instead. You'll get an iron yoke. Death and destruction. Jeremiah later sends a letter to the exiles telling them to get comfortable in Babylon because they'd be there for a while. The Lord has plans to prosper you and not to harm you, but this is only after you've repented and been punished. So now submit to Babylon. Jeremiah no longer is allowed in the temple, so he sends Baruch to read a prophecy, but the king, upon hearing it, attempts to kill Baruch and Jeremiah and burns the scroll. Later, Jeremiah was in a dangerous prison, thrown into a well, and in a brief change of heart, one king actually wants Jeremiah's advice, but he has to do so secretly because he'll get in trouble with the people if he's seen consulting with Jeremiah. Jeremiah hides a linen belt in the wilderness and later brings it out spoiled. Then he buys a jar pot and smashes it. Judah is the linen belt, no longer good for anything. They are the smashed jar that cannot be put back together. The temple officer, Pashur, orders Jeremiah to be beaten and humiliated. When Babylon attacks, he has the gall to ask if God will save them. Jeremiah says, if you want to live, flee. Babylon sets up a vassal king whom Yahweh tells the people to submit to. Instead, they assassinate him and kill a bunch of innocent folks along the way. Many fearful surviving Jews want Jeremiah to tell them what to do, but when he says don't go to Egypt, they call Jeremiah a liar and a brown noser of Babylon, and they do go to Egypt. Following the exile, there will still be a king from David's royal line and a lasting priesthood, which will be established. There will be a new covenant, one not inscribed on stone tablets, but on the hearts of God's people. The last seven chapters of the book are judgment against the nations, including Babylon. The book ends with the summary of Jerusalem's capture. The city is starving, the king's sons are killed before him, and his eyes are gouged out. The temple's destroyed and the holy articles are taken to Babylon. Jeremiah proclaims early on that the heart is deceitful and desperately wicked. We see proof both in how Jeremiah is treated and in the politics of Jerusalem. The very prophet of God is persecuted, beaten, publicly humiliated, and condemned to death for simply sharing God's word. Still, God wants his people to repent, and he's pained at the suffering, even though he has no good option but to punish. Yet he proclaims hope through the royal branch of David's line and a new covenant. Jesus sounds like Jeremiah in his calls to repentance, and he looks like Jeremiah for being persecuted as God's messenger, and he ushers in the very covenant of the heart in his own body and blood that Jeremiah refers to.